In this video, I'm going to give you 5 steps of basic approach towards selling a home or any kind of real estate for that matter. Watch the video until the end to know all these steps involved, because together followed, you will sell your home for sure and faster. Ready? So come on, let us jump in right away. Step 1, you need to become a motivated seller. If you're watching this video, that surely means you are thinking to sell your property. The key word here is thinking. If you want your property to be sold, you need to graduate from thinking to become a motivated seller. A motivated seller has a why, a purpose. There is always a reason to sell their home. Why someone needs to sell their home at all? Is it a financial necessity? Is it a relocation? Is it an upgradation, or you have downsizing in mind? Or let's say simply it's a border. Whatever it is, you need to find out what's your purpose. Find out that first and consider the job is done, since now you are truly motivated with a strong reason backing you. Step 2, research. Now that you have decided to sell, the next step is no brainer. You need to research to develop an idea on your possible selling terms. Research means that you don't know but are willing to find out, said Charles Keating. You surely may not want to go to market with one of your precious assets by guesses, assumptions, and listening to your neighbors who had never sold in their lifetime, right? So spend quality time online with multiple listing platforms. Speak to realtors, check newspaper classified ads, and talk to homeowners like you who had sold in the past in your neighborhood. Remember, those who frame a reasonable selling term backed by the research will clinch a deal faster and others wait endlessly. Step 3, appoint professionals. Congratulations. Consider how the job is done the moment you found out the reason for sale and coming to an understanding of the likely fair selling terms. Now leave the rest to professionals. I remember a popular quote while I'm talking to you about this. If you think it is expensive to hire a professional, wait until you hire an amateur. Makes sense, right? So you only need a bare minimum of 3 kinds of professionals. 1, real estate agent. 2, an advocate. Finally, you need a chartered accountant. A real estate agent is a person who will help you sell your home. When you appoint one, he or she is going to be the single most person with whom you will be in contact at all your times and until your home gets sold. Undoubtedly, you need this person who will represent keeping your interest in mind. Then you need an advocate to help you managing and arranging the title deeds in order and up to date. Sometimes you will be surprised the amount of legal scrutiny the buyers do. So an advocate besides you saves a lot of time. Finally, you may require a chartered accountant or a tax consultant, who is someone who saves you a lot of money when consulting in advance before an event, such as selling a home. There are so many complicated tax laws, and a non-resident has to be even more careful of those by consulting a professional. Googling for answers might not be profitable, my friend. Step 4, get your home showing ready. I always believe the merit of a home is in the beholder of the buyer. What they see is what they believe. If your home looks like this, it is surely going to fail. Or if you have prepped your home to look like this, it is surely a winner. Look for wall seepages, broken tiles, doors, faucets, repair and bring it to order. Repaint the interiors, if not the exteriors, to get a fresh look. Rearrange the furniture and declutter. The devil is in the kitchen. So look for leakages beneath the sink, sidewalls, and keep the refrigerator clean and when loaded, looks pleasant and neatly arranged inside. Let me give you a bonus info. Keep a freshly baked bread or something warm on the kitchen top when you have visitors. They are sure to get a home feeling and get belongingness. You know what I mean, right? Step 5, dealing with offers. Finally, you have started receiving offers and have to deal with it. When your agent presents you with an offer, one thing I am sure is that most of the times it is not going to be 100% of what you were expecting. sometimes a buyer offers you the price but doesn't meet the timelines, or maybe there are price differences but excellent buyer with no outside finance requirements, and some buyers agree to all the terms and vanish just like that without a reason, or there is an offer which exceeds your expectations and you simply don't know what to do at all these situations. Do you want to know the trick of the trade? The first 2 to 3 offers are going to be always quick and great ones. You need to be quick in your decisions and clinch the best ones out of this. I know it is going to be tough, but once you think you would wait for the better ones, remember there is no guarantee that there will be one. You may not be needing the sale process now, but your endless wait shouldn't pressure you when you need it at the most, since real estate liquidations are not immediate most of the times. Although the line between the ambition and the greed sometimes seem quite thin, ambition solves a purpose, and as I recall, you know the purpose of selling your home crystal clear, right? Alright, hope this video was helpful to you in your pursuit of selling your home. I need your help. Can you drop in a word below with your comments on this video and suggest what are all the other types of videos on real estate you want to hear it from me? That would be helpful for me to curate my content to your wish. With that, it's a wrap. See you in my next video.